My name is Manuel Manos Perez, trained out of the Casa Pain Gym in Denver, Colorado. I'd like to thank my beautiful wife, Leanne Perez, my wonderful boys, for allowing me to do what I love to do. I'm looking to go in there and end this night early, come out with a knockout, and look forward to the future.
You all good there?
It's time to meet the main event fighters. First, fighting out of the IMS Heating and Air Blue Corner, please make welcome Lance Lamdown Williams. Insurance Thomas Swenson Red Corner. Please make welcome Manny Manos Perez.
The whole idea of what a fighter is what Perez illustrates. It's overcoming, finding a way. Never look at the record of a fighter. Look at the guys that he's fought.
I'm the last man standing, ain't nobody gonna knock me on the canvas. Damn it, everybody saying I'm a savage, cause when I throw the hands, man, I'm gonna leave you damaged. When I'm going down and out, I'ma fight through the pain till you're down for the count. And I'll be throwing these hands and I'm leaving no doubt in the minds of these haters that have a big mouth. Man, they really wanna test me. Man, you say you got the juice, well, I'll prove it, homie, let's see. Competition is a pet peeve, cause I beat all these lames all day when I'm flexing. Let's see, get me fighting on empty. Ask about the best, I pop up like a bit spring. Homie, I'm a renegade, I'ma fight to the end, and you're Minute Maid. Ain't scared of no man, and you've been afraid. Been doing this for years and I'm getting praise. Man, I'm the type of fighter you dread. I'm gonna have some fun, gonna knock some heads. Better go to sleep, I'ma put you to bed. Cause it's Manos Perez.
Yeah.
I'ma be the last man standing. I'ma be the last man standing. Ain't nobody like me when I'm fighting. Man, you know I got the world in a panic. So just breathe in, breathe out. Just let everything seep out. It's gonna be a ride, better get your seat out. Running through the competition, can't keep count. I'ma be the last man standing. I'ma be the last man standing. Ain't nobody like me when I fight team, and you know I got the world in a panic. So just breathe in, breathe out, just let everything seep out. You're gonna feel bad, but if you seep out, you're gonna be the competition, can't keep count. So when you think that you're tired, let me have a big dog, I'ma take you higher. This ain't no game, and you gotta keep fighting. So get in the ring with the rage of a lion. Let that adrenaline rush to the brain. Let that feeling just drive you insane. We're gonna be like, can't be tamed.
Check, where we believe in slow-smoking all of our succulent cuts of meat. Using the highest quality spices, we believe this is the best way to provide you with high-quality barbecue in Colorado. Wayne Smoke Shack, 406 Center Drive in Superior. Time to meet the main event fighters. First, fighting out of the IMS Heating and Air Blue Corner. Standing 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Professional boxing record of 7 wins and 4 losses. From Muscatine Boxing in Muscatine, Iowa, please make welcome Lance Lambden Williams. And now, fighting out of the Farmers Insurance Thomas Swenson Red Corner, standing 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds, 25 wins, 12 losses, 1 draw. Former WBC Continental America Super Featherweight Champion, WBC Youth World Featherweight Champion, WCB Latino Super Lightweight Champion, WBA NABA Super Lightweight Champion, UBF International Welterweight Champion, and GBU America's Champion. From House of Pain Boxing in Denver, Colorado, please make welcome Manny Manos Perez. This professional 135-pound championship bout is scheduled for 8 3-minute rounds. Referee Stephen Blair.
Here we go, fight fans. It's the main event we've all been waiting for. Lance Williams representing Muscatine Boxing. He's wearing the blue and white trunks, facing off against hometown favorite Mr. Manny Perez in this 135-pound bout. Mr. Perez wearing the camouflage trunks represents House of Pain. And my goodness, what a resume Mr. Perez brings to the cage or the ring with him this evening.
Yeah, you're talking about a guy. He's 25-12-1 his last 7 fights. He's 5-2. And literally the iconic figure of Colorado boxing at this stage of the game.
Perez comes out, defense high and tight. Williams flashes the hook. Landed well for him, actually got around the glove and cuffed Perez on the air. And Perez a little bit staggered as the hook comes up top and gets him on the crown of the head there.
Gotta love a boxer that wears Dave Schultz wrestling shoes.
And the corner of Williams calling for him to counter. You want to wait for Perez to start to make his move and then have him fire off.
You know, JR, Lance Williams coming to us from Muscatine, Iowa, like you said, as we always reference in long fights, the altitude.
Yeah, I make the joke commonly, and it's not really a joke. I've seen guys come to this state from sea level and get winded walking across the parking lot.
I've watched that as well. I really have. I've seen that too. So, you know, I'm very, very curious to see how this altitude affects Mr. Williams coming into this fight.
8 3-minute rounds. So with that having been said, possibly a strong body attack in the game plan of Perez here, knowing that his opponent's coming up in altitude, and see if he can't try to take some of the wind out of his sails.
As I think it should be for all fighters coming in, regardless if they're MMA fighters or boxers or kickboxers for that matter. I'm loving the body attacks that I've seen tonight. It's a credit to the kind of boxing coaching that these guys get here in Colorado.
And Perez told to bring those punches up a little bit. He is the shorter of the two fighters, and he is fighting in a fairly crouched stance this evening, so when he fires a shot straight out, it's almost at the belt line of Williams.
Lance Lambdown Williams, 7-4, all 7 wins by way of knockout. So we're not talking about a guy that can't hit here. We're talking about a guy that starches people with his shots.
But less than half the number of fights of Perez, and Perez been involved in some really big fights. We heard in the introduction the number of championships that he has under his name speaks to the number of big fights that he's been involved in. So definitely Perez has felt the pressure, and that's something that will be a little bit apparent here, fighting in front of the hometown crowd. Of course, everybody wants him to beat up on the guy from out of state.
Right.
10-second clacker sounded. Manny Perez gives his arms a little shake out at the end of the round, and Williams steps forward with a couple punches.
Nice little round there in the first round. Definitely a feeling out round for both of these guys. I think Manny Perez is kind of looking to gauge some distance on Lance Williams being a longer fighter. And I think for Williams, you know, looking to gauge kind of what kind of power Manny Perez brings to the table. Would you see the same thing?
I would, and I'd say Perez has to be a little bit wary of the power of Williams, especially early in this fight, because two of the punches that Williams landed, I saw him mess up the footwork of Perez. I'm not going to say really that he was staggered, but it caused him to adjust his footwork a little bit.
I saw the same thing. And, you know, I really want to see kind of if the status of tonight's attacking is really based on body attacks, because if it is, Manny Perez could have a very quick night with Mr. Williams.
And we'll see if Williams has a game plan of body attacking. Being the longer and the taller of the two fighters, of course, easier for him maybe to land the head shots, looking down onto his target as opposed to Perez that has to reach up for his. But, again, that's partly why they throw the body shots, is to bring that head down.
I will tell you this, though. Lance Williams looks to be in outstanding physical condition tonight.
Couple of stiff punches there for Williams. Has to be careful of leaving that punch out there. He made contact and then didn't bring it back immediately. And somebody of Perez's experience, he'll see that, he'll feel that, and he'll just try to come over the top of it. He'll give you a little bit of a body shot if he thinks he's going to come over the top with a head shot.
Yeah. Nice, beautiful, tight elbows into the body here shown by Manny Perez. Just keeping that defense nice and airtight, really. I do see him kind of leaning over a little bit. I mean, you know, almost pattern-like. I'm wondering if Lance Williams is seeing the same thing and looking to either, you know, pull an uppercut or step to the side and, you know, come over the top. So definitely be interesting to see as this fight plays out, kind of, you know, the angles that Lance Williams can throw.
It does take away some of the body attack that Williams could have with Perez being crunched over like that. The abdomen closed down a little bit, so yep. Maybe Perez watched a little film on Williams. If he's seen that he likes to be a body hunter, especially right up the middle, maybe just trying to thwart some of that by virtue of his stance. And Perez working power gets the knockdown there, and it's the body shots you were talking about, Ron.
That has been the theme all night long tonight. And I have got to tell you, that body attack is really something special.
And the Perez is going to feel this now. And Williams, if he wasn't gassed out from the altitude before, a body shot that makes you drop to your knees, boy, that'll empty your tank in a hurry. And Perez feeling it. Williams looking to keep the elbows in tight, trying to fire back. But Perez being told by his corner, don't get too excited, and they want him to breathe.
Lance Williams almost looked like he was kind of paralyzed there for a second. And I don't know if he was still feeling the effects of that body shot or not, but he seems to have really hit the brakes now. And Manny Perez is really bobbing, weaving, moving, and looking to set up, I'm thinking, another shot to the body.
And look at how tall Perez is now compared to what he was. Has that lead hand down a little bit, still protecting the body, but definitely a much different stance, and a big shot lands for Perez, and he's getting the count here at the end of the round. The round is going to end, but let's see if Williams is able to get up. And I thought Williams was shaking his head no, and this will be the referee's call here, and there's the bell, so we're coming back with the next round. And, boy, you got to say that was a good round for Perez.
Absolutely. I think what you're seeing is he's getting comfortable with the range that he's able to kind of decipher on Lance Williams. And because of that, he's really starting to pick his shots very beautifully right now.
And I'm seeing the referee motion to the doctor. He wants him to check either the teeth or the jaw of Williams. He's pointing kind of to the lip area, saying, hey, go in and take a look at that. And so we'll see what fight doctor Alex Constantinides has to say about this. I don't see him giving any kind of indication that he thinks there's a problem enough that it would be an end of the fight here, but definitely over there taking a look at it. And referee tells the fighters, hey, we're going to go. And Williams shaking out his right hand quite a bit. Let's see if that's something that plays out. Maybe he got an injury trying to land a power shot there. So the jaw, the lips, the teeth of Williams, or excuse me, it was the left hand and the left hand of Williams. Let's see if any of those become a factor. And let's see how hard Perez steps on the gas to start this round, having got a knockdown right at the end of the last. And I don't think Williams is quite clear-eyed yet. Seems to me like maybe he's still feeling the effects of some of those shots, Ron.
You know, I don't know. I don't see that he's hurt per se, but I think he's being extremely cautious right now.
He's moving well. I just saw it in his eyes that he didn't quite look clear, but nothing in his footwork or his punches that indicates what I saw in his eyes. And momentary glance at the referee by Williams.
And the confidence is brimming right now for Manny Perez. He's definitely feeling good about what he's working on right here. You can see it.
Yeah, very, very comfortable in there. In the corner of Perez telling him, don't get too excited. Make sure you keep breathing. But he has to be feeling it here. Williams trying to open up his vision, see if he can detect any of what Perez is going to throw before he does it. But
it looks like he's trying to load up, right?
Yeah, I think so. I think he's waiting to have the big counter.
Yeah.
Now looking to step forward and engage as Williams keeps his hands up nicely on the way out. Oh, beautiful shot there. Right to the liver. You've talked about it all night, Ron, and getting an other count. And the corner of Perez still imploring him, keep it calm, make sure you keep breathing.
And this is really where the experience of Manny Perez pays dividends. I mean, here, you know, he's got his opponent hurt several times already, and now it's really about setting up the shots to pick.
Oh, and that was, oh my goodness, that was.
He knew it.
As much of a perfect low strike as you get.
Yeah, inadvertent, but definitely low. And Manny bowing his head saying, I understand, my bad.
Going to be given a warning there, and Williams being given some time to recover, and time in, here we go. And again, that was just Williams digging for the body.
Yeah.
He wanted to go back to that liver shot, see if he can get Williams out of here. Perez momentarily back to that crouch stance. Now he's switching back and forth. So he's given Williams a couple of looks, and he's hurt him with every look that he's had. And now he's saying, I'm not going to let you know what's coming.
I think right now is where he can kind of put a stomp on, or put a stamp on this fight. If he gets Williams in that corner, I think that, oh, and he's hurt him again.
Williams staggered one more time. Oh, it's a clash of heads.
And there's blood on the corner of Manny Perez.
And there's probably just less than 2 seconds left in this round. And, yeah, it's going to be a cut caused by an accidental headbutt. And we're going to hear the bell here in just a second. So corner of Perez going to go to work on that cut and see if Williams is leaking any chi.
I'm very impressed with the way Manny Perez is approaching this fight. I see a very methodical Manny Perez tonight. Do you see the same thing?
Yeah, certainly not getting overly excited, not going to let himself get punched out. And I give a lot of that credit to his corner because as soon as Williams was hurt, they were telling him, breathe, be patient, be calm. They wanted him to flurry and continue to hit his opponent. They did not want him to be reckless.
Yeah, and you're seeing that patience, you're seeing that maturity, you're seeing that experience really shine through because as a younger fighter, you're going to want to jump in there and try to get your opponent out of there. But what
what we're seeing out of Manny Perez tonight is a very calculated type of attack and really not allowing any type of overexertion in any one aspect or the other.
And Perez, I think, dealing with two cuts. He's got one in the hairline, and he's got another right over his brow. And the hairline one still leaking just a little bit.
That one just opened it, yep. Oh, Lance Williams. Jackhammer of a right hand. He's landed twice now.
And Perez just dropping his hands and letting his opponent come forward. And Perez has the head movement to be able to do that. One more time, digging to the body is Perez. Williams looks to answer back, kind of saying, I need to hurt you as much as you've hurt me, but that's a tough task he's got in front of him to be able to do that.
And I tell you, though, I am sensing a little bit of urgency right now out of Lance Williams. Are you seeing the same thing?
Agreed. I think he sees the blood leaking from Perez. I think he has a target, and I think he wants to try to take advantage of that. Good uppercut there by Williams. Brought the left hand up to cover and the right hand for the uppercut. And I think the referee warning the fighters not to let their feet get tangled. Perez, opponent backed into the corner again.
He's got Lance Williams hurt. He's going to the body again.
And enough blood coming out of that cut on Perez that is starting to show on this body a little bit. And there he is, down again. Going to be another count for Perez. And I think we're going to see a little more urgency from Perez now. I think he feels the cut too. I think he knows that Williams has a target and a little bit of energy from it. And I think Perez is going to try to put him out here.
And that body is the key. That body attack is the key. It's going to set up everything that he wants to use. And he's hurt him again. And I'll tell you right now, he's got Lance Williams hurt. Lance Williams looks like he's about to take a knee.
I agree. He knew that he was in trouble there.
Oh.
Did enough bobbing and digging to it. That's going to be it. Congratulations. Manny Perez goes home with the technical knockout victory, representing House of Pain. For Ron Goldstein, I am J.R. Gordon. Thank you for having joined us ringside here at Sparta Combat League, King of the Ring. We'll see you at the next set of fights.
I'm the last man standing. Ain't nobody gonna knock me on the canvas. Damn it, everybody saying I'm a savage. Cause when I throw the hands, man, I'm gonna leave you damaged. When I'm going down and out, I'ma fight through the pain till you're down for the count. And I'll be throwing these hands and I'm leaving no doubt. In the minds of these haters that have a big mouth. Man, they really wanna test me. Man, you say you got the juice, well, I'll prove it, homie. Let's see. Competition is a pet peeve. Cause I beat all these lames all day when I'm flexing. Let's see. Get me fighting on empty. Ask about the best, I pop up like a bed spring. Homie, I'm a renegade. I'ma fight to the end, and you're minute made. Ain't scared of no man, and you've been afraid. Been doing this for years and I'm getting praise. Man, I'm the type of fighter you dread. Gonna have some fun, gonna knock some heads. Better go to sleep, I'ma put you to bed. Cause it's all heart, Manny Manos Perez.
Yeah.
I'ma be the last man standing. I'ma be the last man standing. Ain't nobody like me when I'm fighting. Man, you know I got the world in a panic. So just breathe in, breathe out. Just let everything seep out. It's gonna be a ride, better get your sleep out. Running through the competition, can't keep count. I'ma be the last man standing. I'ma be the last man standing. Ain't nobody like me when I'm fighting. Man, you know I got the world in a panic. So just breathe in, breathe out. Just let everything seep out. It's gonna be a ride, better get your seatbelt. Running through the competition, can't keep count. So when you think that you're tired, let me elevate, dog. I'ma take you higher. This ain't no game and you gotta keep fighting. So get in the ring with the rage of a lion. Let that adrenaline rush to the brain. Let that feeling just drive you insane. Be the kind of beast that can't be tamed. Leave with the win and endure all the pain. Homie, be about it if you really think about it. I'm the best in the city, can't nobody do it like me. Everybody went and got it, leaving them astounded. I'm the top dog, man, ain't nobody wanna fight me. Every day dedicated, homie, I'll be working. You're gonna pay off, man, it's gonna be worth it. I'ma leave with the win, man, I'm so certain. The last man standing, you know that I earned it. I'ma be the last man standing. I'ma be the last man standing. Ain't
at 2 minutes,
like
21 seconds of round number 4, referee Blay has called a stop to this fight, declaring your winner by TKO, the new Sparta Combat League champion, Manny Manos Perez.
breathe, breathe out. Just let everything seep out. It's gonna be a ride, better get your seatbelt. Running through the competition, can't keep count.
John in the ring with Manny. All right, I'm sure it never gets old, does it? You got plenty of these things, but I'm sure it just keeps getting better as you get more.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it doesn't matter which belt it is or what title we can fight for. I want them all. I'm in this game as an entertainer. Hopefully you guys were all entertained.
It certainly was a fun one to watch as a fan tonight. Take me through that fight a little bit. Was it what you expected?
Oh, absolutely. I knew Lance was going to come here tough. I knew that we had to just show everybody that we're not done yet. 32 years old, but I got a lot of fight left in me. So we'll be around for a while longer.
Happy to see that, man. Looks like you might need to go get a stitch or two in the head, huh?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it comes with the territory. A couple of stitches, no big thing.
What's up next?
You know, go back to the drawing board, correct some stuff, come back. I want to fight on pay-per-view again. I want to open up for another major card. I want a chance at a world title, a legit world title, bring back to Colorado. I want to thank everybody for coming out. I love you guys.
Thank you very much. Some other people you want to thank before you go?
Oh, yeah, my family, the endless support I got over there, all over. I love you guys. Thank you.
Congratulations on another belt. Give it up once again for your new champion, Manny Perez. That does it for the show tonight. Thank you so much for supporting Sparta Combat League Boxing. We'll see you again September 17th at the Grizzly Rose. Thanks for coming out. Drive home safely.
Screaming. Thanks a lot.